हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट क्लास वी लर्नड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मस्कुलर टिश्यू। मस्कुलर टिश्यू कंसिस्ट ऑफ इलोंगेटेड सेल्स, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड मसल फाइबर। दिस टिश्यू इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मूवमेंट इन आवर बॉडी। मसल्स कंटेन स्पेसिफिक प्रोटीन्स कॉल्ड कंट्रैक्टाइल प्रोटीन्स विच कंट्रैक्ट एंड रिलैक्स टू कॉज मूवमेंट। These are of three types: striated, unstriated or smooth, and cardiac. Striated muscles are also called skeletal muscles as they are mostly attached to bones and help in body movement. And this movement we can do by conscious will. So these are also called voluntary muscles. Under the microscope, these muscles show alternate light and dark bands or striations when stained properly. As a result, they are also called striated muscles. The cells of this tissue are long, cylindrical, unbranched and multinucleate. Having multinucleate means having many nuclei. So, these muscles long, cylindrical, unbranched, and they show the striations, light and dark bands, and these are the nuclei. They have many nuclei. Unstriated muscles, the cells are long with pointed ends. These are spindle shaped and are uninucleate. They do not show striations, so they are also called unstriated muscles. The movement of food in the alimentary canal or the contraction and relaxation of blood vessels are involuntary movements. So these are also called involuntary muscles. We cannot really start them or stop them simply by wanting to do so. Smooth muscles or involuntary muscles control such movements. They are also found in the iris of the eye, in ureters and the bronchi of the lungs. Let us see the cells of these muscles. These are spindle shaped. Ends are tapering and middle portion is broad. This is the nucleus. The muscles of the heart show rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout life. These involuntary muscles are called cardiac muscles. Heart muscle cells are cylindrical, branched and uninucleate. They also show striations. So they show the striations. These are the nuclei and they are branched, long, cylindrical and branched. So these are three types of muscle fibers. Next, we are going to start nervous tissue. All cells possess the ability to respond to stimuli. Stimuli, the change detected out of the body or inside. However, the cells of nervous tissue are highly specialized for being stimulated and then transmitting the stimulus very rapidly from one place to another within the body. The brain, spinal cord, and nerves are all composed of the nervous tissue. The cells of this tissue are called nerve cells or neurons. A neuron consists of a cell body with a nucleus and cytoplasm, from which long, thin, hair-like parts arise. Usually, each neuron has a single long part or process called the axon, and many short branched parts or processes called dendrites. An individual nerve cell may be up to a meter long. Many nerve fibers bound together by connective tissue make up a nerve. So this is the diagram of a neuron or neuron unit of the nervous tissue. It has the cell body. Cell body, the nucleus and the cytoplasm, this portion which we say the cell body. The cell body which has these branched parts, these are called dendrites. So this portion which is called the cell body and this elongated part that is called the axon. This is cell body or cyton and this elongated part that is called the axon. These are the nerve ending. So when they receive the message, so from here through the dendrite it goes to this cell body. From the cell body it passes to the axon and this nerve ending which is attached to another nerve cell. So from here it goes to the another one. Likewise from the receptor or the sense organs it reach to the brain. Brain from the through these neurons send the message to the muscles and muscles take the action. So the signal that passes along the nerve fiber is called a nerve impulse. Nerve impulses allow us to move our muscles when we want to. The functional combination of nerve and muscle tissue is fundamental to most animals. This combination enables animals to move rapidly in response to stimuli. So today we have completed this chapter. Thank you, children.